break it down. Lies, rumors, rumors, the lies. Yeah. Lies, rumors, rumors, the lies. 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 Who's spreading all the rumors? Who's telling all the lies? Solo fell off? You must be drinking St. Ives. I'm back in effect on my second cassette. Check the untouched rep. Scaring them seeds like a bomb threat. Rumors and lies at the same time try to destroy my name. Is this the price for fame? If people got money for rumors and talk, they'd have a lot of millionaires living here in New York. Three number one hit, she killed an edge of the vibe. Solo's name and fame can never be denied. It's got me trapped in a corner and I want to attack. I tried to hold it in before, but now I can't hold it back. I can't hold it back. I can't hold it back. I wrote Spellbound to put my face on the map. But rumors have it that another man made in jail wrote. That's impossible. Kevin Madison will take a stand if he wrote Spellbound. Who the hell wrote Letterman? We should have made the non-believers there become a witness. When I released the hit,
tell your mind I'm out of business.
It went number two, not far from one. But while the fugitive ran, I came back to get the job done. Now they want to tell lies and take credit from a great hard worker solo artist. But this is Adam said, I came back for 92 when the Sam Snead track. I tried to hold it all in, but now I can't hold it back. 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 Cops would arrest me before, but now I'm on a tour. So what they knocking at my mother's door for? The cash made me receive the money I was worth. But solo couldn't change, cause I was taught first to remember who you are and where you come from. It won't be hard for you to become number one. I don't like crowds around me ever. Only a true friend can become an enemy, so I stay solo forever. I like it that way, but I hate when people say put me down on the record so I can get paid. If I bring crews and other MCs on stage and help everybody else, I never stay paid. So I write rhymes for solo and help myself. So when I get there, I can give another brother help. Kevin's sub-organization left others in that spot. I tried to hold it in before, but now I can't hold it back. And those who thought I fell off were really surprised to see KSOLO throwing down. And all the rumors and the lies that they were spreading couldn't keep me down. Back out my face, keep my name out your mouth. This record got you cornered and there's no way out. Solo killed all the rumors cause I had to attack. I tried to hold it in before, but now I can't hold it back.
Lies, rumors, rumors, the lies.
I can't hold it back.
Lies, rumors, rumors, the lies.
I can't hold it back.
Letterman. I'm the incredible Letterman. My room was a laboratory owned by my D.A.D. dad. He was a professor, and I'm a S.O.N. So my life as a professor had just begun. My name is K-E-V-I-N-M-A-D-I-S-O-N. One word experiment, I qualify, become a good professor in medicine. I ran out my door, and I looked for a breakbeat spelling book and grabbed my dog. Rhymes that I had on the muscle from his body. The combination of that began to strip the rock a party. I thought that I might get H-U-R-T heard if I used dad's molecular machine. That was known to convert no manual that I could find on dad's machine. I hit a button in his room to turn the laboratory green. Some headstones for my dogs and a pair for mine. Hit the switch to spell the rhyme, my chromosome will mix with mine. This uncanny combination shall let the world understand. Professor Kevin Madison changed to the incredible Letterman.
K-E-D-I-N-N-I-T-I-S-O-N, the O-D-T-E-R, I'm the incredible Letterman.
P.O.P.S. The sun and K.S.O.L.O.S. B.B.L.E.S. S.E.D. Blessed with this brand new hard rap. H.I.T.E.S.P.E.L.L. My style B.O.U.N.D. My sister C.O.O.K.I.E. Told my sister T.H.E.R.E.Z.E. that I can get P.A.I.D. and N.E.W.A.Y. Wait, they told my sister S.E.I.L.A.N.A. Now my whole family's H.A.P.P.Y. Consolers banking all over Z.M.O.N.E.Y. I.W.R.I.T.E. to keep the weak MCs wishing they can all B.I.T.E. The M.U.S.I.C. or plain as G.A.Y. to me. My R.A.P. flows and rhymes a kick, a G.R.A.N.D. grand, cause no one spells rhymes like Letterman. Lord of the Black Luther, no killing rap in alphabetical order. I'm addicted. A double D I C T E D to S P E L. My rhymes in my M U S I C. Or plain as D A Y to me, my R A P. My flows and raps incredible than ever F O N D found. I'm sure the viewer can U N D R T S T A understand. No one spells rhymes like Letterman. K E V I N L E T T E R. I'm the incredible Letterman. Solo in the house, you know what I'm saying? Pete Rock in effect with CL Smooth, you know what I'm saying? My man John on the board. Haha, his squad in effect for 1992. The L-E-G-D-E-R-M-A-N, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Or Kim in the house. Mind of a prisoner whose life fell. Visions of black hands gripping steel bars from a jail cell. No window to see a thought cemented my mind. One, I didn't believe that they can hold me from a crime. Fingerprints, Kodak, front, side, and back. Enough to make a black man flip. I wasn't guilty of jack. A judge couldn't budge. The black robe served another brother. Top of that, I couldn't budge. My face was brown, so his hammer slammed down and hit a brown desk. My court case put to rest. They grabbed my records, cracked cell 31. He got 5 for 15. Job well done. Another nigga behind the wall. Cause their white ball hit the 8 ball. Game over, that's all. Hope was lost as I toss and turn in a man's hell. Writing rhymes from a jail cell. Premonition of a black prisoner. Off of the P now. Premonition of a black prisoner. Release Madison society owed me. I wrote, tell the world my name and now we'll see the whole world knows me. I got caught on the shakedown, riding my name on the wall, so then I used my name to write my Spellbound. And jail I never got to visit, cause my girlfriend's moms that made me write. Tell your moms to mind the business. Now cops play fugitive behind the wall, COs get bum rushed. One got shanked and died in the mess hall. Roll call and mates locked in, yeah, who killed the CO? A tier of 50 black, yell CO, we don't know. 1 out of 10 of them are innocent of the crime. Some were framed, but at the wrong place at the wrong time. Of them is a man who didn't do nothing. He fits a description of a black man who raped some white pregnant woman. The look on his face tells the world he didn't do that. Though he's in jail for conflicts and murder isn't on top of that. He'll get framed for killing a dead CO, a life of Donald's wife and children, and cops say so. The CO found the shank in the cell. They grabbed the man by his neck and then they told him that he'll die here in jail. And as cops beat him and mistreat him, the black man hung himself cause death was his only key to freedom. All because of the wrong description, he died in a black premonition of a prisoner.
I'm just showing you how it is.
The premonition of a black prisoner.
Like the dude that was standing up there in the middle of the yard hollering and stuff like that. That's what he was hollering about. He hollering at the world, you know what I'm saying?
The premonition of a black prisoner.
It's like he died. You know, that dude upstairs is hollering out the window. He died. Just showing you how it is, you know. That's what these people, I'm just showing you how it is, you know.
Break it down. Yo, what's up, man?
Yo, what's up, man? Solo, where you going?
Yo, I'm gonna go up there to Foot Locker spot, man. Get me some Pumas, man.
What kind you get?
I don't know, man. I'm thinking about getting them Pumas, man. The high top with the Velcro.
Yo, remember
the old school Pumas, man?
Yeah.
Pumas just went out, man. The brothers played Pumas out, man.
Well, we gonna bring them back.
Yeah, definitely, man. We definitely gonna check out these Pumas. Check it out. I was in my house looking at a pair of sneakers that I ran through and asked my mama if she could buy me a new pair of sneakers for school. She said they watch your sister and after I push up I'll give you 50 bucks and you can go to the Foot Locker spot. I watch my little sister,
yeah,
just like she told me. Mom gave me the $50 she said she owed me. I ran to the store, the Vacia Mall, and seen the inventory of the sneakers and grabbed them from the wall. A black pair of Pumas, the kind that you can slide on, and asked the man there, hey, can I try these on? Took my sneakers off down to my socks, tried the black Puma sneakers on, the shrunk and fell in the box. I landed in a village called Shoehorn. The sneakers came to life and said they kid put us on. I was scared for a second, cause I know sneakers don't talk. But I was barefooted, ever needed something to walk. So I put them on my left foot, then partner on my right. Was walking down the block and yo, the sneakers that I walk are feeling tight. If my mom finds out she flipping, never let me wear a pair of sneakers again. Shh, it's on the sneak tip.
Wear my sneakers?
On the sneak tip. Don't tell the soul it's on the sneak tip. Was acting afraid. You could tell by the way the Puma sneakers behave. They said, hurry now, before the weirdest night started chasing. All we gotta do was follow the yellow shoelaces through the village of Timberland. I seen a boo who was in trouble, laces tied together, so I untied him on the double. He said his name was Tim. I asked what happened to him. He told me about the other boots that worked in Timberland. The other work boots without a steel toe used to get work, but without a steel toe will get hurt. So I told him to come with us on a trip. Shh, don't tell a soul, this adventure's on the sneak tip. Sneakers for me again. Shh, don't tell a soul it's on the sneak tip. On the sneak tip. Don't tell a soul it's on the sneak tip. On the sneak tip. I even met a girl named Avia, whose body was fat. Guys flip when Avia would walk around the track. A friend named Fee
Live was also Rebel Fly. Size 6 with a red bone and a stripe on the side. A man's name was Reebok. Reebok left the box, so I jumped in the box and I left a lace of knots. She said if he finds out he's gonna flip, so I said don't tell him. Shh, this adventure's on the sneak tip. Cover rubber soaker bump, T-Rain and got Adidas. And then some bullet formers pumped the last sneaker. Who stuck us late in Feline's hole, was caught dead, hanging from a telephone pole. The boomers were more scared than shocked. Then they told me that you had to mess with Feline, and now you're gonna get shot. I told Tim that I'm out of here. He said run till the wizard of a sneaker caught fit to wear, cause if I get shot, mom's gonna flip and never let me wear a pair of sneakers again. Don't tell a soul it's on the sneak tip. See the things that I saw, sneakers all running around, and then he stopped. They were told by the wizard of a sneaker to get back in the box. And then I heard a voice that was coming from a speaker. It got louder and louder and deeper before my sneakers got afraid and said, let's go away and come back another day. I said, chill, don't be afraid. The tin boot said there's something moving in the box. I reached for the box, but something said stop. But I got a mind of my own, so I kept on towards the box, kept on to the box. Then I lift up the top from the box. I found out the wizard of a sneaker was a man in a box. I said, you're really nothing but a faker. He said, yeah, but on the sneak tip, I used to be a shoemaker. And I came here as a young man and gave life to sneakers. And yo, they called me Tom again. I said, well, I don't mean to be rude, I need your phone. To call my mom, he said, hey, kid, better yet, I can get you home. He put me in a box, then pressed the dome. Said, rub your laces and say, there's no place like home. I did just that nonstop, and I was in the Puma box, coming out of the Foot Locker spot. He pulled the sneakers, cause you know I did. And I ran with the high top boomers all the way to my crib. When I ran through the door with the burst of joy, I heard my mom flipping.
You've been gone for 3 days, boy.
But I couldn't tell mom, cause she was flipping. Never buy a pair of sneakers for me again. She don't tell a soul it's on the sneak tip. Sneaker World Premiere. Yeah. The baby that she had didn't look like me. The baby that she had didn't look like me. The baby that she had didn't look like me. I was dealing with this girl that I used to go with. She wrote me a letter telling me that I got her pregnant. For some reason I thought it was true, so I went through all the things a man with a child's supposed to go through. We broke up 6 months ago and now she's having a baby. I'm hoping it's a boy so I can name Solo. I called her on the phone, her mom knew. I told her to mind her business. That's when she told me that her daughter wasn't home. I walked to a crib, knocked on the door. Her sister said she wasn't feeling well, but asked me could I walk her to the store. She came to the door, then a Porsche. She started arguing with me, asking me what was I standing there for. Her stomach was bigger than I expected, and the worst thing I could do now was make my ex-girlfriend neglected. I broke the ice and said, ma, how small were y'all? She showed me some books she got from the doctors on the stuff they call Lamar's. We got back together, I was the father to be, but the baby that she had didn't look nothing like me. I should've knew in the beginning that something was wrong, and all the guys that went through this, you know the name of the song.
Show me where you're coming from.
You know the kid's not my. A lot of men who've been through this before, just because the girl says she's having your baby doesn't always mean it's yours.
Show me where you're coming from.
You know the kid's not my. A lot of men who've been through this before, just because the girl she's having your baby doesn't always mean it's yours. Maybe it was a sister one day acting out and pretty, cause the man wants some tickets in this place in Atlantic City. My girl, she called me on the phone, wanted me to meet the one to take her there. But yo, I said I wanna stay home and started the biggest argument. I said, hey girl, hold up. She said that it is over, and then she hung her phone up. 8 months down the road, I never did know that Ray gave us other extra tickets to his friends so James can go. James and my girl hit it right off. They stayed in the same room in Atlantic City from morning night to noon. When she came back from a trip, she got sick. She went to the doctor, he said she's pregnant. Then she told her sister, and her sister told Ray, and they told James, and they was all surprised to hear what he had to say. James replied, you're telling a lie, I just met you. He hung up and said, the baby's not mine. That's why they said he didn't want to be bothered. So she wrote me a love letter, saying I'm the baby's father. I knew in the beginning that something was wrong, and all the guys that went to this, you know the name of my song.
Show me where you're coming from.
You know the kid's not mine. A lot of men who've been through this before, just because the girl she's having your baby doesn't always mean it's yours.
Show me where you're coming from.
You know the kid's not my. A lot of men who went through this before. Just because the girl she's having your baby won't always mean it's yours. I even got a job at Burger King cause I wanted her and me and the baby to have nice things. I moved in her apartment. It must have been love then, cause I could tell that's where my heart went. For some reason her mom was being real nice to me, cause now she knew I was a big part of her family. Driving me around in the caddy, telling the whole world her daughter's pregnant by me and I'm the baby's daddy. We went to Lamar's Friday, Saturday and Sunday. I took the early bus home so I can go to work on Monday. When I got on my side in the chat with my girl for hours, signing some invitation just so she can have a baby shower. Her family members came and gave her gifts. Her mom's put her seat in the living room so she can open the gifts. The toys that she got was cool, but the clothes wasn't enough, leaving me and Burger King to buy the big stuff. I bought the Pampers, socks, bottles, shoes, cause all those things the baby's father's supposed to do, I should have known from the beginning that something was wrong. And all the gossip went to this, you know the name of the song.
Show me where you're coming from.
You know the kid's not my. A lot of men who went through this before, just because the girl just she's having your baby don't always mean it's yours.
Show me where you're coming from.
You know the kid's not my. A lot of men who went through this before, just because the girl said she's having your baby doesn't always mean it's yours. When she gave birth to the child in the hospital, I got a ride there by my man Sam, all Kim and Ricky Kittles. When I got there, my face was covered with joy. The doctor said, Mr. Madison, you had a proud baby boy. I jumped up, screamed, yelled terrific. The nurse put a pen in my hand so I could sign my last name on his birth certificate. That's when I felt like a man. They put the baby that didn't look like me in the palm of my hand. He didn't have my eyes, my nose, my face, or my complexion. I kissed them both and showed them both affection. That's when I told my girl, when in them Kevin, that's when her mom's Ray James, her sister walked in. Nobody said nothing, my girl stood there by the crib while James was looking at himself in the mirror and looking at my kid. That's when she got up and slammed the door. I grabbed him by his neck and asked him, what was he looking at my son like that for? He said I had sex with that girl there in Atlantic City. I'm sure that y'all gonna see the child looks like me. I said to myself, you the baby's father, though we have the same shirt, same face, same eyes, same ring around the collar. My girl tried to explain, he ran to get the last name changed, but I was too busy then trying to hide the pain. I wanted to punch, fight, scream, kick, holler, but then it all just hit me. You're not the baby's father. I knew in the beginning that something was wrong. And all the guys who went to this, you know the name of the song. I know a lot of men who've been through this before. Just because the girl says she's having your baby don't always mean it's yours. You knew the kid wasn't my. A lot of men who've been through this before. Just because the girl says she's having your baby doesn't always mean it's yours. Yeah. You knew the kid's not my. A lot of men who went through this before. Just because the girl she's having your baby don't always mean it's yours. And this goes out to guys who never been through this before. Just because the girl's having your baby doesn't always mean it's yours.
Yo.
Yo.
On the strength, man.
We gotta get in here, man.
Hold up, that's Wookers.
Solo and them niggas is in there, man. They all cooling out.
How you get in here? How Dave and them get in here?
Yo!
Solo rapper, right?
Yo! Come on, yo, let us in, man.
Ain't buying that butt up.
Come on, man, it's us, man. You know us. It's your last week.
Oh, niggas on front now. All right. Yo, go get Richie in them. Yo, tell Richie to come here. Get Richie right there.
Yeah,
right there. Yeah.
Bring him over here.
Yo, Rich, what's up? Yo, get us in, man. Go tell him to go get Solo. Yo, hurry up, man.
Go ahead.
You got a 40, right?
Listen, you gon' come in. If you gon' come in my place, you better act right, cause you started a whole bunch of stuff here last week. Alright, now listen, come in. They start some trouble, I'm telling you, everybody gon' go. Come on, keep it straight.
Back up. Yo, on the strength, you don't back up, man. You gonna turn the sounds off. Yo. We're gonna turn the sounds off. Yeah. Back up. Check it out. To the beat, y'all. Yeah. Attention, business, the microphone mutilator. Before I make Master Madison rap crooked, cause he don't rap straight, then I shine. We thrill. A chamber went around, make it kill it will. If moving fast was a meter, still the harbor make a hit. The subjects I kick, the points in the target. The crowd sees eyes, and all the rapper captain.
trigger. Bullseye, tough like Tonka. You freak with my rap flat freestyle, but it can't be conquered. I took the rap main floor, that's what I cut for. So how the hell brothers fight my fate for? I'm here to let them know that it's the same type of flow, the formula that makes solo. Now if you got more dollars in your pocket, put a piece out of there, be from the South Bronx and say hell yeah. Say hell yeah. My mic broke some lasso, holding them Z's up so I can tear them all a new asshole. I was always on till now I'm standing. Punks wanna run and leave the microphone abandoned. Okay, if that's the way they really wanna play, I sneak up on these punks and catch them another day. They used to say I never stay paid. My posse heard it from the Prince Street and ran into a rampage. On your projects and your development, don't try to hide or run a lie, cause it's irrelevant. With the Zika patch in your face, I'm bashing, constantly snatching in the case, solo fashion. Yo, this going out the brownfield, you know what I'm saying? On Lodge Avenue, Newport Garden, on the case, solo, you know what I'm saying? Red Sat, you know what I'm saying? To the Vulture Posse, somebody just say, make money, money, make money, money, money. Solo was staying alone, but I can blow an arm of your weight. Myself's got out, that's all I need about the rhyme style. Swallow overflows around the right take lead. I'm a vocalist, try to take a vocalist. You might die from the fire or collapse from the smoke of it. The mic's pipe hot, with jokers in the spot. Solo packs a full house, and lose the jam with the jackpot. I juice the king of Spain, I love the green, I hustle so much. I bust the jack of diamonds down the drain to win the royal flush. So keeping it on to the break of dawn. King Solo's on the mic. Now check it out, y'all. Put your peace on in the air. Yo, 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 niggas is fighting. Yo, 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 turn the music on. Yeah, yo, we out, man.
Black America, tell me who's killing who. Black America. Let's stop and think about ourselves for a minute. We don't help ourselves. We're gonna hurt ourselves. Black America. Killing each other, dying in the hands of a young black sisters and brothers. They're killing their own race. Go anywhere in black America and you'll see that's in your face. To watch black America cry, knowing she don't wanna die. I brought this to light to keep them alive. We gotta change the reflections of the majority of you in the mirror of black America. Tell me who's killing who? Black America needs. Black America, tell me who's killing who? Black America. Black America, tell me who's killing who? Black America, please. Black America, tell me who's killing who? Drug dealers are doing the sharing our community, destroying black America. Brother, where's your unity? And Central Road, the subject of you, let's talk about the weaker point of black America. You sell your drugs to a kids, don't need a meal, they date the mob, the biggest customer. They're home starving cause you're always selling drugs to her. And what did you do with the money? You went and bought more drugs so you can make more money. You kill our hope and dreams right in black America's eyes, letting the future know that drugs is a way to survive. If we don't respect one another and help one another, we'll destroy one another. And that's what they want, my brother. You killing me and I'm killing you. Now stop and ask yourself how can the black dream come true. We gotta change the reflections of the majority of you in the mirror of black America. Tell me who's killing who? Black America needs. Black America, tell me who's killing who? Black America needs. Black America, tell me who's killing who? Black America needs. Black America, tell me who's killing who? Black men gotta stop calling their women a bitch. Your mother's a black woman too, so that makes you a son of a bitch. This is the wrong word to use, my brother. That same word kept my black woman back in the gutter. Nobody was there to pick a black lady up. In black America when times was rough, you didn't care anyway, cause she was that to you. My point is black America, tell me who's killing who. We fought together, lived together. If we don't get it together, we'll all die together. Cause all we got is each other. Black American girls and boys and black fathers and mothers, get involved with the children. It starts at home. The black America we save could be our own. We gotta change the reflections of the majority of you in the mirror of black America. Tell me who's killing who. Black America, tell me who's killing who. Killing me, killing you, black America. Who's killing who? Killing me, killing you, killing me. Black America, tell me who's killing who. Killing me, killing you, killing you, killing me. Black America, tell me who's killing who. Killing me, killing you, killing you, killing me. Black America, tell me who's killing who. Killing me, killing you, killing you, killing me. Black America, tell me who's killing who.
You.
Yeah, 1992, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Can solo back in effect. 1992, can solo stepping back in here.
You know what I'm saying?
Woo. Yeah.
Check it out, soul man.
92.
Yo, Red, you know what I'm saying? We gonna tell this little story about all these girls we used to bang when we was young. Brothers seem to don't believe us. So, I guess I'll start by telling you a story when I was young. When I first got paid, check it out.
It wasn't 77, well, at least I think so. Way before the people knew me as K-S-O-L-O. We moved from Queens to Long Island, and my mom's added maid. But mom was working two jobs. She said, son, I want me a maid. We went to this agency that was on Broadway, so mom could fill out the papers and see about the maid. When we got there, we seen the man who sat behind the desk. He said, I'm sorry, miss, but ain't too many good maids left. But I'll show you some pictures of all the maids we got here. I looked and seen this maid who looked like Pam Grier. I said, hey, mom, let's get that maid. Ooh, she looks like my teacher. Mom said, okay, and asked the man, can we meet her? He pressed the button, said her name. She was there in a flash. My son some papers, gave her money, and everything was done fast. On the way home, I could look and see she looked young. And by the way, she had me laughing. Ooh, I knew she was fun. But something was wrong, I couldn't figure it out. Till one day, me and the maid were alone in my house. I was in my room reading a book. She came inside my room naked and told me, Kevin, take a look. From her feet to her body, I stared at shock as I stared at her breast and a hairy for box. She had a real bad body. I was put in a trance, busting up out of that trance, and she unzipping my pants. She wrapped the legs around me. She began to tease me, whispered in my ear, do you think you can please me? I said yes, I could confess. And then the maid grabbed my young hand and put it on her grown chest. She started seducing me right there on the floor. She said, the better you'll get more and more. She just started moving fast and she started going, I'm coming, I'm coming. I said, stop, where are you going? She paid me no mind, I guess she knew I was young. I guess she said this for kicks, but I was having my fun. And she went up and down and side to side to make things slippery and wet. As I went inside, the maid moaned and groaned, moved my hips, blew in my ear, held my face and with the tongue at my lips. I was only 11 and in the 6th grade, no one believed that I made love to the household maid. No one believed that I made love to the household maid. You know what I'm saying, Red? No one believed that I made love to the household maid.
Yo, P, man, what's up?
No one believed that I made love to the household maid. No one believed that I made love to the maid.
It happened again when I came home from the bar. Mom was working late and the house looked dark. There was a note at the door that said my dinner's in the oven. Steak and potatoes with blueberry muffins. But before I can get any food in my jaws, I seen the bra and a woman's panties on the living room floor. Where could she be? Cause this I'm sure mom could never see. The neighbors in the room butt naked cleaning the room for me. She grabbed my comic book and put it on her behind. Opened it up and said, hey, read between the line. I love to read about the Incredible Hulk. But when the maid grabbed me, she created the Incredible Hulk. On the floor by the AFX track, sweat coming from the back. Mom's working, we don't know when she'll come back. I'm only 11 and in the 6th grade. No one believed that I made love to the household maid.
Yeah. K-Solo back in here for 92. Throwing niggas to the curb.
My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them like a bolo.
My microphones rock heavy and my mic stands bent. Words have been any soft song, cause all my rhymes are made of cement. When I add wise words, water with compound, resorts to earthquakes when my mic hits my ground. Vocabulary I wrote from a stone age, I wrote a concrete rhyme on asphalt and got paid. Bricks and cinder blocks enter my mind, full as I from words as small as gravel to hard paved rap roads. I won't forget where I'm from, I thank God for stardom. I'm a hard rock from the rock bottom.
My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them like a boulder.
I'm from the rock bottom.
My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them
like a boulder. I'm from the rock bottom.
My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them like a boulder.
I'm from the rock bottom. The K's my home, the 2's my room. I sit on the center block and watch all my ideas bloom. I'm sitting in my room and I'm thinking, my world is soft as water, and just because I'm hard, I'm sinking. If I can live life like a bridge and remain hard above the water, that's the way I love to live. I air hard rhymes on my recorder. This means London bridges come tumbling down. Now I'm in the water like a pebble or rock or a brick. I can't swim. I'm bottomless, drowning in my rhythm. I'm from the rock bottom.
My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them.
I'm from the rock bottom.
Rock bottom. My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them.
I'm from the rock bottom.
Rock bottom. My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them.
I'm from the rock bottom.
Rock bottom. My rhymes are heavy like a rock, so I'ma throw them like a boulder.
My words will stick to any beat Sam makes like cement. My DJ sidewalk scratches lily pot holes in the pavement. Two stones make his headphones, they hear the cuts, kill the amp to make my mic amp the tombstone. My hand holds a boulder, my army of pit bulls protect me, the hard rock soldier. Four paws with lock jaws, got him. Yo, yo, my style's aggressive, I'm from the rock bottom. I'm from the rock bottom.
Rock bottom.
Case alone, it's from the rock bottom. I'm from the rock bottom.
Rock bottom.
I'm throwing niggas to the curb, you know what I'm saying?
It took me 16 months to write, tell the world my name. 2 more years almost went by before I picked up a mic and recorded another hard album of my thoughts and premonitions. Every last part of me is sold to the world on tapes, records and CDs. Put my face on the poster so the world can view a man with problems, but by the grace of God I got through. Maybe because the jams I wrote, but you imagine everything I'm rapping about. What's happening to you? I'm trapped in yourself. The only me that they can all find for freedom to write rhymes and express yourself. I laugh remembering the cell calendar counting release to the rock bottom, but now I'm king of the mountain. Off the mountain. Off the mountain. Off the mountain. Off my own mountain. When my mom married my dad, she wasn't in a good position. She was pregnant with me when my father was a musician. Dad played at the Apollo for one-night gigs. They said my father had dreams of making it real big. So daddy played and performed show after show. But for him and mom and me, they said it wasn't enough dough. Dad dropped the music and got the J-O-B. Mom moved out to Long Island there where she gave birth to me. I was named after her and her father by her. They named me Kevin Charles Vaughn Madison III. I went to motor school and took a lot of music lessons, as I was taught as a child. Music was an obsession. Now I get paid with the mic in front of a crowd. That's all behind me now. My reward is the newfound crown. King of the mountain. Up the mountain. Up the mountain. Up the mountain. When I was a small kid, I used to spend days alone, cause my mom worked two jobs and dad didn't live home. I used to talk to my dog and myself, and when my teacher found out, she said that ain't too good for your health. She called my mother up, my mom panicked, took me to some sites, some doctors. They thought I was some schizophrenic on the couch. I was talking to some man I don't know, and all I kept on telling him was that I wanna stay solo. He said, hey son, you gotta mingle. Show me a picture of a goofy finger pointed at a shingle. That's when they put me in the roof. He said, hey, if your house had a shingle, then your house would have the roof. I said, I understand that's cool, but I don't want nobody smiling in my face at my home or in my school. Jumped up and slammed the door, and I begged my mom to never bring me to that man anymore. I climbed myself, and that's all behind me now. My reward was the newfound crown, king of the mountain. You know what I'm saying? Anybody can be king of the mountain if you get to yourself. Find yourself. Search your soul. Be the king of your own mountain. Give yourself a chance, please.